Good evening, everybody. Greetings from Lord's Hospital, Trivandrum. This is a video presentation mainly on hemorrhoids, in fact, MIPH, minimally invasive procedure in piles. This was requested by the Medtronix Limited as a webinar presentation last month. Before going to the video presentation, I would like to tell you something about hemorrhoids. Look at the anatomy of the anorectum. You can see the anorectal ring, the valves of Ball, ischiorectal fossa, the external sphincter and the internal sphincter. External sphincter, as you know, it has got three parts, the subcutaneous, superficial and the deep part. And this is the superior rectal vessel dividing into two branches mainly. The left joining around the 3 o'clock position. And the right branch divides into two, the 7 o'clock and 11 o'clock positions. And this is just to show how the external sphincter, levator terni, from which the external sphincter is developed, the deep transverses, superficial transverses, perineal body, bulbous spongiosus, etc. And this is the anal canal. In fact, the anal canal is only 4 centimeters from the anal verge. Here you see the subcutaneous part of the external sphincter, superficial part and the deep part, and the internal sphincter. Piles is not a disease, but it's a condition that most human beings experience. In fact, it is more than 30% in the population suffering from hemorrhoids. Incidents keep rising with advancing age. They are dilated arteriovenous plexus, in fact, covered by mucous membrane. There are so-called internal hemorrhoids above the anal verge, covered by mucosa supported by the longitudinal muscle. And the external hemorrhoids stay outside the anal verge, that is covered by no muscle, it is covered by skin. They are not just a venous disease like varicose veins. They are dilated arteriovenous channels. Arterial supply remain normal. Venous drainage is hampered due to sliding down and prolapsing of hemorrhoids. Constipation is the main cause. Morinka in 1995 said arterial ligation helps shrinking of the hemorrhoids. What are the symptoms? Mainly constipation, bleeding and protrusion of mass. Presentation, already said. Then you need a rectal examination, digital examination. I normally use my left index finger rather than right. Patient remains in the left lateral position with both knees up. That's a position which I use. A proctoscopy, obviously, and investigations, nothing very much other than the routine. You can, you must definitely do an ultrasound scan of the abdomen. A CEA in the elderly above the age of 45-50. A sigmoidoscopy when necessary, a complete colonoscopy. And what's a medical treatment? Plenty of vegetables, fruits and fluids. Fruits, not less than 3 liters. In hot climates, maybe between 3 and 4 liters. Fiber containing vegetables, fiber supplements, regular exercise, cut down meat and meat products. The procedures available ever since this was being treated as only sclerotherapy, not many people do that anymore. banding, still some surgeons are practicing. It's not, it's an old procedure again. Cryosurgery, few surgeons are doing. Still, that's not a bad idea for early hemorrhoids like grade 1, grade 2. Laser coagulation, infrared coagulation, radio frequency waves, and so on. Conventional hemorrhoidectomy by Milligan Morgan. Here what they do is removal of the hemorrhoidal mass is completed by ligating and cutting it away. Three triangular wounds are made with a void base at the end of the dissecting area, at the end of the dissectant, and ligating the bile mass. This dry area takes a long time to heal, and most of the time that produces a stricture in a good percentage of patients. It is not anymore, and also it's quite painful. The problems are pain, time taken for the raw surface to heal, and possibility of anal stenosis. We adapt a simple procedure at Lord's called the S technique. It's a two-finger anal stretch actually. Never dilate the anal canal which is patulous. Whenever there is spasm, when you introduce finger, you will know actually if it's a tight anal canal. Even under a spinal anesthesia, you can still feel actually the space available. In that case, you do a two-finger anal stretch and you must be able to pass three fingers so that you can introduce the speculum as well, the anal dilator and the speculum you have to use when you are doing the MIPHR, the stapler surgery procedure. And also, so the second thing we do is a little cryo at 3-7-11 positions for 1 minute each. Then you ligate. You can feel, in fact, the artery at 3 o'clock, which is larger than the ones at 7-11 positions. You can definitely feel if you have a sensitive index finger, you can feel it. And if you go down by 5 to 6 millimeters down and take 1 centimeter bite distance, that will definitely include the vessel at 3 o'clock and also 7-11 positions. Then what we do is snip off the skin tags and suture those, skin to mucosal suture, with 4-0 chromic catgut. This is suitable for first degree and second degree or grade 1 and 2 hemorrhoids. This is one of the very effective procedure for early hemorrhoids. We do umpteen number of them, like the stapler hemorrhoidectomy. That is a large series which we'll discuss about it in detail when you go to the video presentation. The dot-plugated hemorrhoidal artery ligation, those who want to do that, it's nice again, it's a good procedure. Then what is the other thing? The MIPH, minimally invasive procedure for partial prolapse and hemorrhoids. It's very effective. Recently I've been doing it is much more than a partial prolapse. It's almost a complete prolapse, I would say, about 4 to 5 centimeters down. With a double stapler, I could fix it. The advantages of MIPH, it is the pain is markedly reduced, fast recovery, no external wound, and rare chance of recurrence. What more you want? There is always distortion and descent of the distal rectal mucosa and anal mucosa with plexus of veins. The new surgical approach, there is correction of this alteration and circumferential excision of hemorrhoidal plexus and mucosa. It is in fact a rectopexy as well. That's an advantage. Now you are going to watch two presentations, two patients for you to watch. The first one is ready with a grade 3 hemorrhoids. I've done the 3-finger anal dilatation, adequately sufficient to pass the anal dilator with the obturator, that is done. Sometimes I use the obturator to pass faster to dilate the anal canal as well. Sometimes that can be done as well. It's a fairly large one and to dilate the anal canal. Now that you have the anal speculum introduced, the bite is taken from 6 o'clock position, goes round, and easily 3 to 4 centimeters from the edge of the anal speculum, that is easily 5 to 6 centimeters from the anal verge, you go all around, actually 3 to 4 bites from each quadrant, almost 12 to 14 bites the entire distance if you cover, 12 bites easily. And obviously you come back to 6 o'clock position. You are almost there. And it is not super, very superficial, it is fairly deep bites. If you take superficial bites, you will include only the mucosa and they will be bleeding. You have to go at the submucosal level, you have to lift the anal plexus as well. There is no bleeding from anywhere. In fact, it's large hemorrhoids. You are introducing the gun, the instrument, open it almost completely, not fully. Then it is easy. Then after fixing it, then you open it completely, lift it up, find the adequate space to lie them behind. That is, yeah, it's a double suture ligation. So it is fixed around the head of the instrument, and this thread is taken out through the side holes in the instrument, and it is again ligated tightly behind with a pull given downwards and backwards. Yeah. Generally fix the anal speculum, hold it, square it with your left hand or the assistant's left hand, and now you are going to close the instrument that is tightly closed, and the red line must come in the middle of the you can see that red line is come, and it is fired already, and the whole thing is gone in, and the arterial venous plexus, which is responsible for hemorrhoids, that is intersected and divided, actually that is divided. This is a reinforcing suture taken above and below the suture, the stapler line, above and below the stapler line. In fact, the stapler line at 3 o'clock, 7 o'clock and 11 o'clock is covered by the mucosa, that's a reinforcing suture. Even if there is a bleeder, you can definitely fix it using a figure of eight suture, above and below the suture line. But you are not going to pass through the stapler line. Here, what are things you have to remember? One is, if you are doing it in a female, make sure you fix a gauze in the vagina and not a rounded one, a flat gauze, so that whenever you take a bite, actually, you can make sure you are not taking a bite from the vaginal wall. When you close, you must be able to take the gauze from the vagina, and if it is encased, you will not be able to take the gauze from the vagina. And also bleeding or disruption, you can always suture inside. It is not just like suturing outside. Whenever you suture outside, it goes transversely, but when you suture inside the anal canal, the suture goes up and down or vertically. And in fact, you can go all around and switch as well. There is nothing to fear about. It is not a difficult procedure task. And one more case I have to present. This is in fact a second degree hemorrhoids with fissure. This patient was having a lot of pain after passing stools. It lasts for about half an hour, 45 minutes after passing. They present with fissure. You can see the posterior fissure, in fact. And most patients coming with fissure will also have at least a grade 1 or 2 hemorrhoids. And whenever there is fissure, and they have a fear of passing stools, and the sphincter goes into spasm, this will hamper the drainage of the venous plexus. Actually, whenever there is spasm in the anal sphincter, and that will hinder the drainage of the veins. This is fairly easy one. Again, the same thing, about 6 centimeters from the anal verge, and at least 3 to 4 centimeters from the point or edge of the anal speculum, not the anal speculum, the anal dilator. The speculum is one that is moving now and starts from 6 o'clock to 6 o'clock, about 10 to 12 bites or even a little more than 12 bites. Come back to 6 o'clock. Repeat the same procedure. I always put a reinforcing figure of eight suture at 3, 7, 11 positions, and so that there won't be any bleeding at all, and you don't have to come middle of the night after a stapler procedure. That is something which discouraged the younger generation from taking up this procedure. This is a very beautiful surgical procedure for grade 2, grade 3, grade 4 hemorrhoids, and simply goes in, and it's in fact an anopexy as well, and there is sliding down of the anorectum, the lower anorectum, and this is fixed back in position, so it is a anopexy as well. Sometimes you find when you pass sutures, you get a hematoma, like nothing to worry. Hold a swab against the bleeding point for a minute or so. The hematoma will settle down, nothing to worry. Otherwise, if you leave it, the hematoma will start filling the anal canal. So nothing to worry. Sometimes you pass through the vessel, blood vessel, that might produce a hematoma, but immediately hold a swab at the bleeding point and give a pressure. And you can see actually, tighten, the red line comes to the middle of the green, and then fire, and release, and gently take it out. You can hear a click actually when you fire. And you can in fact see the suture line, the stapler line, not the suture line, the stapler line. You know, one of the innovation is that in this procedure, the prolapsing mucosa and the redundant skin are excised circumferentially distal to the subcutaneous part of the external sphincter. The circumferential cut is achieved using an harmonic scalpel, or also you can use bipolar diatomy. This is the procedure, yes. See how it is cut using a harmonic scalpel. It's coming out. Yeah. This will eventually look like a colostomy in the perineum. Rather than the conventional traditional surgery that gives you a broad roadmap only, but the surgeon will have to redesign many procedures, I suppose. Actually, there are many ways of doing it. If you have a mass that is prolapsing outside, not being able to take it in, then you can do such procedures also. And stapler procedure is one of the best procedures right now available, and it is in fact rather than disconnecting the arteriovenous plexus, it also fixes the hemorrhoids back in position, they say, anorectopexy as well. Thank you.